Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm starting a new series of videos where I will cover all the main use cases of the tool to solve with LangChain. Today we will be speaking about test summarization. For those that are following my channel, I already upload several videos about this topic. Today we will be focusing only on LangChain. We don't the LLM use in this case is going to be OpenAI, but it's going to be secondary. I prefer today just explain you how to solve this use case and the different alternatives that we have for that case. Let's go first of all to look a brief overview of all the use cases that we had available on LangChain. As you may see, we have Q&A, working with SQL data, Tool.js query analysis, code understanding, structured chatbot, summarization, etc. I will try to cover all of them one by one with examples and as today and going into all the possibilities that we have with LangChain. Summarization is covered. It's one of the main or the most simple or the most typical probably or one of the most typical use cases that you can solve with LangChain. And as you well you probably know, this is just take a test and provide a summary or provide a short text that contain the main idea that contains the test that you pass as an input. The test can have an arbitrary length and depending the size of the length and the number of characters that you had on this test, you may choose one of the different options that you had to solve to solve the tax in with LangChain. Essentially you had the three possibilities. You can use the chain stuff, mat and reduce, and refine, which is here on the bottom. I will explain you now one by one. When you use stuff, usually is when you have a short text and you can just simply reduce or summarize the test in a single go. What does this mean? That your test is small enough to suit in a single call to the as input to the LLM that you are using to the LLM that you are using for to summarize the test. If the text is bigger than the input that you have, that the LLM that you are using has, you need to split the test in chunks. And then in that scenario, the stuff option is not suitable. Then, depending the size, usually the size of the input size of the LLM is 1024, but this heavily depends of the model, obviously. If you have, for example, like today we are working with OpenAI with ChatGPT Turbo 3.5 Instruct, and then this model had 4096 tokens as input. Maximum input is 4096 tokens. Then again, depending on the model that you are using, you can use here, as you know, you can integrate this with Llama, with a commercial or non-commercial model. And then again, depending which one you are gonna use, you need to decide either, first of all, decide which option, which chain you want to use, which version of the summarization chain you want to use. And secondly, if you need to use a version where it's necessary to split the input, you need to also decide or understand how you want to split the text, the size of the chunk that you want to use to use as a input of the chain in the second and third option, that is reduce and refine. This is somehow kind of critical because depending how you do it, if you create very small chunks, you have a lot of documents to summarize. The math and reduce version is iterating through the documents, the chunks that you the in which you split the document, and then finally creating a summary. And then if you create very small chunks, these chunks are not capturing the how to say the sense of the meaning of the document that you want to summarize, and especially for documents that are very big, this is not how to say suitable. You need to do you need to create chunks that are closer to the input of the LLM that you are using in order to capture as much as possible the sense of the document that you want to summarize. There is models that are specifically designed to do summarization, like Claude, and also the big models like GPT-4, GPT-3.5 Turbo, or Gemini, which had a very big input size. They are also suitable for that activity. For using models that are how to say smaller in terms of parameters, you may need to do some experimentation and decide which one is the suitable size chunk as in, that you will use to split the document. Just to give you an idea as well, every token in average is in between 4 to 5 characters, so just this gives you an idea how big had to be the chance that you will need to split your document. And then, okay, let's continue. Stuff is, again, you have a single document, and it's your document just suite the input of the LLM you are using, use this option. Math and reduce, again, you will need to split the document in chunks, and those chunks will be the input of the chain, and what it will happen here, you will enter in a loop where the LLM will summarize all the chunks in the first iteration. You will summarize all the chunks, then you will join all the summaries, and the chain will calculate again if the document is summarize enough or not. It is summarize enough, you will get an output. If not, it will enter in a second loop where it will split the summary produced by the first iteration, split the document again, and summarize the document again, join the summaries in the second iteration, and do the check again. So you enter in a loop until you get a document which is enough summarized. And again, here is key in understanding what is the size of your LLM and what is the in order to prepare the chunks as closer as possible to the size of the input of your LLM. In the case of the refine, it's slightly different. It's also you enter in a loop. You take but this case you have as an input all the chunks that your splitter produce, and you take the first, you summarize, and you introduce this summary in the loop, and then this way you make again the splitting, summarize, and again this way you do it iteratively until you finish the summarizing the whole document. But what you are doing is introducing every time the summary of one of the first chunk into the loop. So this way, this the third option is slightly more slower than the math and reduce option. So again, you need to do some kind of experimentation before you apply one of these methods, and again, depending of the LLM that you are using, you will decide what you will decide what is the more appropriate side of the chant to use for that, to do this task. Okay, so I prepare an output that, as I said, I will post it later on the repository as usual, and then we just install the libraries we need. We mount our drive, because in the drive I had the, one of the documents, a book that later we will use to do a long summarization. Connect to OpenAI. Yes, we use the also the OpenAI class from LangChain community. With this we are using the model GPT 3.5 Turbo Strat. With temperature equal zero, we don't need to be creative here, we just need to be to summarize and to capture the meaning of the document. We are going to use the prompt template class. This essentially is to create a prompt for the to give some instruction to the model. And this is a class as well from LangChain. And then you can see here, I just instructing the model to summarize a text in lines and produce and format the outputs in lines on no more than 30 words. And after every line, return introduce a return line. And well, I just try to guide the LLM to provide an answer which everybody, even not being a specialist, just in case that you are introducing very technical text, no, that is not how to say difficult to read for somebody who is not close to the matter that is this text, you can put something like that just to try to guide or to try to in that the answer that produced the LLM is easy enough to understand for somebody that is not close to the matter that you try to summarize. No? Here I just take an article from BBC, and it's regarding some strikes in American airlines. And well, just create the prompt with the method prompt from the class prompt template. You can create it like that. Here you just I just print the prompt and just invoke the LLM. So here we are calling the sending a request to the OpenAI model with the prompt and printing the output. As you see here, well, it's producing a summary of the given text. The next example we will cover is summarize a book. In this case, we need to use, we are using the log summary change. Here we will apply one of the methods I showed you before. This here, that I showed you, you can use it as well as we are going to do now. Today, now we are going to use the, as you will see here, the math and reduce. The previous example, you can do it as like the second that we are going to see now, but with the option staff. We can try later on if you want. So here what we are going to do is use the class, the main method, the load summary change from LangChain, and also the splitter. We are going to use as a splitter. Well, this is just a splitter from LangChain which takes the text and divides it in chunks of a given size. You will see now. So I take a book. This book is The Great Gatsby. This is one of the examples I use also in the previous videos I upload to the channel. Here just we calculate the number of tokens. Here we split the text in chunks of 5,000 characters. Just to give you an idea, 5,000 characters is round about 1,000 tokens. We can also here probably give a bigger chunk size. We can even provide probably 20,000 as a chunk size, but I just wanted to show you how well how it's done in using two different sizes, one smaller and the other one in a second try we will do it bigger, no? A bigger chunk. We also use a chunk overlap. This is you are going to take 300 characters from the previous chunk and 300 characters from the next chunk. And the separators is what the language used to split the is looking for these characters, and it accommodate splitting the text using those characters, and later accommodating the size to 5,000 in this case. It shouldn't be, at the end is not getting always the 5,000, it will get 5,095 or similar, or but always smaller than 5,000. This is the maximum size of the chunk. So doing the splitting this way, we get 63 documents. And then one comment that you need to know, one note is to work with the LangChain chains, you need to produce LangChain documents. So the splitters produce LangChain documents, and any other class which is working with inputs, so this is reading data, splitting the data, this can be PDF readers, CSV readers, TXT readers, readers from a database, whatever is reading the input data from LangChain, produce finally a LangChain document. The LangChain document is the everything that you input to a LangChain had to be in that format. And the LangChain document essentially is a class which contains a main attribute, which is the page content. In the page content, you had the text. Here is the text that comes from we are taking the first document that is generated for this recursive text split splitter, and then on the text produced by the first chunk is this one. You can take the link. Let's do it here in a second. And you see 4,746. As I said, the maximum size is going to be 5,000. So it's accommodating the size to something close to the chunk size, but never above that. Then on the document, apart of the context, had another attribute that is metadata. One second. Which contain. In this case, it doesn't contain anything, but other splitters that you may find on LangChain library, it will provide here some context, for example, the number of the chunk or the document from where this information is coming from. This is very common, for example, where you are reading a pandas data frame or a PDF file. Some metadata is applied here, for example, in telling you where the row of the data frame or the name of the file where from which this information is coming from. This metadata later can be used to refine for example the queries, or just to as an additional information to you build your chain. Here we use again in this case the mat and reduce method with the 63 documents, and then here we are just preparing the chain. We pass as a LLM the LLM that we create above with OpenAI GPT 3.5 Turbo. The type is math and reduce, and you can, if you introduce verbose, it will produce all the intermediary steps. It's producing a lot of info, so we will not do it in this case. You can try it at your convenience. And here you will see that it's not taking long, but it's just reading the 63 documents and one by one creating here now a summary. Okay, so now we can create as well the what we see here, for example, with this text, sample one. And now instead to create a chain from MathRadio, you just write stuff. And we produce as well the let's write this. Okay. Again, that's all. It's not not much. It's a topic that is quite easily solved with the LangChain. Here, also using OpenAI is making everything very easy because well, it has a very long input size. We can try as well now giving the text a different size. For example, here let's do a different, for example, 15,000. Okay, we have now 20 documents and we can just use the chain because I hope that is no problem. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So here again, depending on the LLM that you are using, you may decide to increase or reduce this. It's going to have an impact at the end of the day on the summary. Big chance is going to run faster, obviously, because in this kind of change, you need to do less iterations and then less calls in to the model to the function generate. That is what is doing it under the hood, calling the generate method of the LLM. Again, this is something that is going to impact at the end on the summary. You see here the summary. Well, we can make a comparison of this together with what we get here. So having longer chance, as you can see, make a more rich summary. If you had a smaller chance, is also providing a small summary. So again, depending on the how you do the split of the document, how long is, and also the LLM that you are using for your change, is going to have an impact in the final output. And well, that's all. We will continue with the next topic in the next use case, that it will be Q&A systems, but later we will see this in a separate video. And that's all. I hope you like it, and as I say usually, if you like the video, just give me a like, and if you are not subscribed to the channel, it's now time to do. Thank you. Ciao. Bye.